Garry Kasparov is probably the most famous chess player in the world. In 1985, at the age of 22, he defeated 32 chess computers simultaneously.
To me, that was the golden age. Machines were weak, and my hair was strong.
But a bit more than 10 years later, technology caught up with him. And in the mid-90s, he got beaten by IBM's then-supercomputer Deep Blue in a pair of 6-game chess matches. He was devastated, but what he learned from those matches is the essence of how we should look at digital health and the upcoming AI revolution. Kasparov's fight with Deep Blue was highly publicized. Newsweek called it the brain's last stand. A documentary film made of it is called The Man vs. Machine. There's a long narrative throughout our history about us versus our creatures, the machines. Although Kasparov was at the forefront of this almost mythological fight and got beaten by a machine, he learned something that we should all pay attention to.
I was Mount Everest, and Deep Blue reached the summit. I should say, of course, not that Deep Blue did it, but its human creators, Anand Tharman, Campbell, Horn, Sue, hats off to them. As always, machine's triumph was a human triumph, something we tend to forget when humans are surpassed by our own creations.
A machine's victory is our own victory. When Kasparov played Deep Blue in 1996 and 7, it was the first sign that artificial intelligence was catching up to human intelligence. Deep Blue relied on brute computation force. It was capable of evaluating 200 million positions per second. 2 decades later, Google's AlphaGo went into battle with a much more superior and sophisticated system to fight against the Go world champion Lee Sedol. It was publicized as a David and Goliath fight once again. But we shouldn't look at neither Deep Blue's or AlphaGo's victory as a defeat for humans. It's the ultimate triumph, because we are the creators. And it's also not the dawn of the human mind. It's the beginning of something new.
While licking my wounds, I got a lot of inspiration from my battles against Deep Blue. As the old Russian saying goes, you can't beat them, join them. And I thought, what if I could play with a computer, together with a computer at my side, combining our strengths? Human intuition plus machine's calculation. Human strategy, machine tactic. Human experience, machine's memory. Could it be the perfect game ever played?
In 1998, Kasparov set up a new kind of chess competition. He called it advanced chess. The idea was to play chess against a human opponent while both players use a computer chess program to assist their decisions. Kasparov dropped the man versus machine narrative and explored what happens if man and machine work together. And in 2005, another tournament produced a revelation. Grandmasters and top machines fought for the first place, but ultimately, the winners became a pair of amateur American chess players operating 3 ordinary computers.
Their skill of coaching their machines effectively counteracted the superior chess knowledge of their grandmaster opponents and much greater computational power of others. And I reached this formulation. A weak human player plus a machine plus a better process is superior to a very powerful machine alone, but more remarkably, is superior to a strong human player plus machine and an inferior process.
So what does this mean? It means that if we invest into our technological revolution, if our machines become more intelligent and we are not afraid of using them and cooperate with them, they will not replace, but they will make us superior. As the medical futurist, one of my biggest goals is to change the narrative from man versus machine to man and machine, helping and supporting each other. And if someone like Kasparov, who essentially lost in that mythological battle between us versus them, could see the greater good, we all can.
We don't get to choose when and where technological progress stops. We cannot slow down. In fact, we have to speed up. Our technology excels at removing difficulties and uncertainties from our lives. And so we must seek out ever more difficult, ever more uncertain challenges. Machines have calculations. We have understanding. Machines have instructions. We have purpose. Machines have objectivity. We have passion. We should not worry about what our machines can do today. Instead, we should worry about this, what they still cannot do today, because we will need the help of the new intelligent machines to turn our grandest dreams into reality.